This may be a game people were not expecting me to review, but after I gave this game my undivided attention, I decided it was worth me making a review on. So for the review this time around, let's take a look at Runbo. Runbo certainly is not your garden variety type of presentation. It definitely is outshined by the AAA titles on the Wii U, but despite this fact, I actually really do like the graphics of this game. The character models look just great and they flow very well into the game, which I can say is a great accomplishment for 13AM Games given the art style of this game. For the actual levels, they are pretty good, but there wasn't really anything that blew my mind. The platforms are portrayed in black, and the platforms that are affected by the background shifting colours are again just fine. The sound is pretty much like the graphics, it's perfectly fine and fits the game well, but there really is not much that blows my mind. However, I will give my credit to the music. There are some music tracks I really do enjoy and get me pumped up to run a course. But of course, unlike the Big N, 13AM Games has been kind enough to allow us to turn the background music off, so if you do not like the music, you can turn it off. All in all, the presentation is good. There isn't anything I find wrong about it, but at the same time, there is not anything that blew my mind either. Yeah, there actually is one, but don't get excited, it's very lacking and the only reason for you to play it is to unlock costumes and characters. Honestly, I would say that story is Runbo's biggest weak point. Considering we have appearances from Shovel Knight, Gun Vault and a bunch of other original characters, I'd say these could have made for a really good story. But instead, all we got was a bunch of original challenges that are issued by a woman named Satura. Yep, that's literally the plot in a nutshell. Do not play this game if you're looking for a good story. Runbo bluntly does not have it. The gameplay to Runbo is very much like a normal platformer, but adds in the twist of the changing background and the characters racing to reach the trophy. When the background colour changes, it will have an impact on the actual stage. For example, if I am about to jump on a mobile platform that's green and the background happens to turn green, that particular platform is no longer there for me to land on. Now on paper, this may sound like Runbo is based on luck, but the good news is that's not the case. You are given the tools to deal with situations that you come across. For starters, after your first jump, you are given a second to use, and then you can use a recovery move for a third jump. Players of Super Smash Bros. Will immediately understand this concept, as the concept in that game is very similar to this game. Considering how fast the background colours change, it's highly likely that the tools that the game gives you, you will be able to stay afoot without falling to your doom. Running and jumping is not your only options in Runbo. You're also given two attacks that come in the forms of a super forward punch and a ground pound. These are very basic, but can be used to your advantage. So how does all this come together? Runbo is the type of game I would call basic but fun. Once you jump in, there really is not much to think about, and to be honest, I'd have it no other way. So all in all, the gameplay is fun and can even be addicting if this is your cup of tea. The content of this game is actually pretty good. You have a bunch of game modes to pick from and the character selection is good as well. For the game modes, there is a decent variety. You have the adventure mode and there is a bunch of modes for local multiplayer. And better yet, there's even online, so thank you very much 13AM Games for giving us this. Considering the fact that this is an indie game, I am actually very impressed about how many modes this game does give you. You may be lacking in story, but Runbo definitely makes up for it when it comes to content. Runbo is a lot of fun and does bring an experience that I am hard pressed to find in other platformers. I will admit, it's not the best game on the Wii U, but considering the game does not even cost that much to buy, I actually think it's worth more than what 13AM Games are asking for. Sure, the story may be lacking and the presentation doesn't blow my mind, but I am willing to admit, I really do enjoy this game. Runbo scores an 8 out of 10.